Tony and Corey here, your weekend warriors. We're back on the Trex project.
And today we're talking about rain escapes.
Today we're going to talk about rain escapes specifically. We're going to give you the features and benefits of the product, some value engineering tips that benefit the homeowner and the contractor, and just explain to you really what the product is.
Yeah, first Tony, let's talk about what Rain Escapes is. It is a under deck drainage system made by the Trex company that uses a really thick plastic trough that you install under the decking but over the joists. So it actually does two things. It takes the water that drips through the deck and runs it out to a gutter system to make it completely dry underneath.
What does Rain Escapes consist of? I mean, give me the list of items that you would need if you were installing Trex Rain Escapes.
Yeah, well, it's a pretty simple system. It comes with this heavy-duty plastic roll. We call this the trough. It gets rolled out in between each of the joists. It comes in two colors, brown and black. So whatever works well for your application, you can choose. It also comes with 4-inch tape to go over the seams, and then a caulking made by Trex that's specifically designed for waterproofing their system. Now, one of the other things that you can use is a product called Trex Protect. This will go over any areas of the joist that you aren't putting rain escapes on, and it protects the joist from water seeping in through the top. Other than that, the only other thing you would need to think about is a gutter. The downspouts hang down and you have to put a gutter underneath them to capture all that water and run it to a downspout and out to your drainage system in the yard.
And the gutter and those lower downspouts not included in this product line.
Correct. You have to think about that ahead of time and have somebody that installs gutters, or you can install your own gutter, but it has to be done.
Perfect. All right, Corey, what are some things to consider to maximize the value that you get from the Rain Escapes product?
Yeah, that's a great question, because as in anything, you want to try and get the most value for your dollar.
Sure.
And as it is with Trex decking, it comes in 12 foot, 16 foot, and 20 foot. So if you build a 19 foot deck,
you're burning some material.
You're cutting a foot off of every joist and throwing that away.
Yeah.
So sometimes it makes more sense to extend your deck out to be 20 feet.
Right.
Or if you're adding a picture frame around the perimeter, you're adding another foot there. So it's just something to think about in the design stages. It's not gonna cost that much more and you have a bigger deck to deal with.
Right.
So the same thing applies to Trex Rain Escapes. The trough material comes in 12 foot and 16 foot lengths. So it's something to consider when you're designing your deck. The next thing I would say, cantilevers. A lot of decks have what's called a cantilever, which is when the joists cross over a beam and cantilever past it. The homeowner opted not to take the Rain Escapes out to the edge of the deck. It can be done. However, it adds complexity. Since we're adding aluminum signature railing to the top of this deck with post lighting. So every time you create a penetration through the Rain Escapes, you're asking for a leak. It can be done, but it definitely adds complexity. You have to use a lot more tape and caulking to ensure that water does not penetrate through where the wires or the bolts for the posts go through.
Whenever you're adding complexity, you're adding dollars.
Exactly.
So do you have any other design tips?
Well, the last one I would give you is if you're putting rain escapes on a deck, but not the whole deck, you would want to use a product called Trex Protect. Especially in this application, there is a slight elevation difference between where the Trex Rain Escapes is and where it isn't. So it could potentially be noticeable when you walk on it.
The transition
between Trex Rain Escapes and not. So if you use Trex Protect on the areas where it's not, then it will reduce that height differential and you probably won't even notice it.
Perfect. That's a great tip actually.
All right, Tony, let's talk about, for some of our viewers, what are the biggest features and benefits of Trex Rain Escapes?
Well, the obvious one is that you're adding outdoor living space, not just outdoor living space, but covered outdoor living space underneath your deck. And you and I both know from going over the cost versus value report every year that that covered living space, outdoor living space, has been climbing the charts. So this adds really great resale value to your home. The next one is that it adds life to the frame of your deck. You know, most decks fail first in the underframing. It's pressure treated lumber and it's got a lifespan, and it doesn't seem to be ever as long as Trex.
Right.
Like the Trex decking lasts for a really long time and the framing is always the first to go. So this protects the framing from all of that moisture underneath your deck and adds longevity to the frame of your deck. So it'll last as long as your Trex decking.
Yeah.
Unlike other deck waterproofing systems, Trex RainEscape allows you to install your own soffit on the underneath side of your deck, which looks really good. And of course you can install speakers or appliances like a ceiling fan or lighting underneath there, which you can't do with some of the other products.
Yeah, I think it adds a ton of value to the deck.
It does, it's a great investment. It also adds longevity to the life of the deck, and they're gonna be really glad that they chose it. And we hope that you get an opportunity to use Trex RainEscapes on one of your projects in the future.
Thank you so much for tuning in. If you like this video, please make sure you hit the like and subscribe button down below. We'll see you next time.